What's happening? I'm back. My new part has arrived for the central locking system. As you can see, plugs all looking nice and shiny. It's come in this nice little box. Instead of using the old one, which is manky and knackered, just an early days thought that I've been having compared to the Sprinter that I've just done. I think where it's a big commercial van, a lot of people are scrapping them. They sort of use them to the end of their life. Don't really care about them and then get rid of them. With T5s, I don't think there's that sort of thing where it's got this camp heritage thing. People want to convert them into vans. People keep them for a long time, look after them. And that's why there's no spare parts around in comparison to the Sprinter, where it's super easy to get parts for it because so many people scrap them. Just to give you an idea of how much this one circuit board cost just for this job. £334.33 just to replace that. So yeah, not best pleased. But what I'm going to do now, before I put my lovely new board back in, I'm just going to go through this old head here and just clean these pins on this. I just want a nice clean contact, so I'm going to go through and just check that there's no rust or anything like that on the pins. Just double check that I get all this grot out of them. Before I put my nice new ones in there. Kidding. Literally just started raining, so I'm gonna have to stop everything I'm doing. Fucking nightmare. Is it rain or? So where I poked that little hole in, it seems to have worked. It's a lot of water, I can see just from where the mark is on the plywood. Has been dripping down there and just run down here, just made the air a bit wet, so just dried it off with my lovely tea towel. And I'm just gonna leave that there for now. Still waiting for this damn fan. Yeah. It's just started raining now, so hopefully it'll stop in a minute. Okay, so the rain hasn't really stopped, but I'm just gonna carry on anyway. I'm pretty happy with those plugs now. Before I plug them in, just gonna double check the battery is disconnected from the other day, and then yeah, should be good to go. So the bonnet is up. Just going to check the battery quick. Yep, negative nodes off, so the battery is disconnected. Plug this baby back in. Fingers crossed. We have some luck. So the new module, you can ask me which one it goes in. I don't have a clue. I know the big ones are going in the middle. Nice safe sounding click. What side has this one got on? I'll have to check on my video. So I've just been to check and the plug is on the right hand side. So back to the drawing board. Plug. Screw fixes there, right hand side. This little baby clicks in there. Right. So now just to reconnect the battery. I really hope this works. Good connection on that. What the hell is going on now? That's not the good news I was hoping for. So as far as pressing the unlock button and the doors unlocking, I've had zero success on that one. So the problem must be beyond what the eye can see.
Beyond what I see.
So I'm going to check the manual again, maybe try and reprogram the keys. See if that's the problem. If not, I guess it's cut the wiring loom open and see if there's any water related faults actually inside here on any of the joins, and maybe rejoin some of the cables. But yeah, all the fun jobs for me. Okay, so tell me if this isn't as clear as mud. Use the key to unlock the vehicle mechanically using the driver door lock. Done that. Press the button on page 26, figure 15, 1 or 2, in the remote control key. If you go to page 28, so press lock or unlock. I must say, I know the sun is shining, but being sat in here, it is lovely and warm. This stuff is beautiful. The floor's nice and comfy now. I can have a little sleep in here, but no. Back on to retrying the program. So you would not believe which absolute genius has just managed to solve the problem. That, my friends, is the sound for remote key working. I actually managed to program it myself in the end, because this box down here has done the job. It's just the key then wasn't programmed, so it needed reprogramming. It's something a bloke charges £120, now I know, to come out and fix for you. I've done it myself, so pretty proud. Big shout out to the Volkswagen T4 forum, who have the instructions on there, much clearer than the manual, which just basically said, oh, just chuck the key in it and just try your best. That's how I interpreted their advice. But yeah, that has cost me £500 when it could have cost me £250 if I just did it myself from the off. So lesson learned there. Maybe don't call out a professional when you don't actually know what the problem is. Now I've just got to do the other key. So for anyone wondering how the hell do you program a key, you need two keys. So your two driver's keys. And I'll go through the instructions on here now and basically explain it, but it's incredibly simple for what you think programming a key would be. So step one is to switch the ignition on. Step two is to lock the vehicle door. Door locked. Using the remote key fob, press the unlock button. This should make the horn sound once, which it didn't do. Wait for 6 seconds and press the unlock button once. Is that going to be about six? Guessing about now. Nope, just had a click in this box. It's good. The remote control will now be programmed. Switch off the ignition. Remove the key from the ignition and check the operation. Both keys working. We're rock it up, baby, and good to go. Woo! Yeah, thank you, Volkswagen T4 Forum. Very, very helpful stuff. Just got to remember to unlock the door now.
Hey, Isn't it lovely when things work?
So that, now that I know that there's this issue here with this box, I'm just going to cover it up with a plastic bag just to save any problems with it again in the future. You'd think there'd be a little casing or something around this, but evidently not. Just tuck that under there, just to keep that nice and dry and protected, prevent it happening again. And now I'm just going to put the seat box back on here. Yeah, maybe one last hoover out, and then we're good to go. Just a damn glove, just... All I'm doing now is just lining these bolts up. Something that makes this a lot easier is if you ensure that you get all four bolts sort of threaded on a little bit of the way, just so you get them all lined up before you start tightening them up. I've already got the front ones in, which is why I can crank these ones right up. Otherwise, if you tighten them up before, it's quite hard to move the seat and line the holes up at the same time. Just where you've done them up too tight, that just restricts you and your movement. So, yeah, no, now I'm just going back to the front one to tighten them up, which have already been lined up. So, not the best angle, but I'm just trying to get them up there. So another little upgrade I'm planning on doing, another easy win, is this the cracked wing mirror. So I've got my replacement one just here. So yeah, hopefully, yeah, I've ordered the right one. Don't know if you can see, but it looks about right. So look at that. Whoa. Nice and shiny. Yeah, now to get this under here, I think it's as easy as just popping it off, removing a wire, popping the new one on. So we'll see how this goes. I don't think that's meant to come out like that. Yeah, so, well, that. There's no cable actually on this one, so I'm hoping the new one should fit. And there you can see the difference between the new and old one. I heard a click. Should be good to go. Another easy win. And how much smarter does that one look? Out with the old. So I completely forgot about filming. So now I'm just putting in, when I did the last van, I accidentally bought two of these water caps. It's important at this sort of stage that you want to do all the cutting holes in the van sort of early on. Reason for this is, as you can see, I've had to pull a little bit cladding out. It's not too big a deal now,
But once you start getting timber on here, it's just going to be an absolute pain in the ass to try and fit anything like this. So I've got to try and cut a hole in the van that big. I don't know how big that big is, but it's bigger than my 76mm drill bit. So it's going to be a bit of a pain in the ass to do, because see, there's not a great deal in it. So I should be able to get up to this size. And then I'm hoping just with a hand file, just to go around, make it a little bit wider. To mark my hole on, what I've done is I've just pushed this up to the side of the van here and just got a permanent marker in the inside, and just in the hole on the back of it, just made a little hole that'll give me a rough center. So I'm gonna drill through the center of my hole here with, I think it's a 6.5mm drill bit. The reason I've chosen 6.5 is because the bit that then goes onto the end of that is 6.5mm. So that should slot straight through the hole afterwards. Give me what I'm hoping will be a perfect circle, and I can go from there. If I get that light in here. I don't know if that's better or not. Here, back here. Maybe that's pretty good. And I'm through. So what I'll do is, the reason I've done a small hole as well is I can now go around and check the positioning. Double check that I'm happy with it before I take it any further. Obviously if you're not happy with it, move your hole. So that's where it is, position wise I'm pretty happy with that. I haven't got too much choice either way, but I wanted it nice and low so it's not within eye shot too much. Fred is back. Freed! It was a bit scary doing this kind of work because if you mess it up, you make a right mess. So now I'm just going to attach my largest drill bit onto. That fits through perfectly, which is great. So to do these, you just gotta get a little, can't see, little flathead driver in there just to loosen this off. So I don't know if you can see, this has got like two little studs. Those little studs sit in these holes here. So I wanna line those up. So what I do is screw that on, pop our holes up, and then we can screw from the back this down, tighten them up back up. That's nice and solid, not going anywhere. Chuck this in our drill. Just double check that it looks about right. I'm actually going to cut from the other side. Time for the scary bit. If you get this wrong, there is no going back. You've got a big hole in the wrong place in your van, so fingers crossed I'm in the right spot. So it looks about good there, I'm not too close to the curvature on the wheel arch. And we're through. So that's what we're left with afterwards, and you can see, nice hole. So I'm just gonna cut my thermal liner just to get it out the way of the hole. I don't know if you can see, it's razor sharp, so being careful. Then I'm just gonna go around trying to keep as circular a shape as possible until I get to the exact size where my water filler cap will just slot straight through there. So now I've just got a rounded edge file. I'm just going to go around. how far off you are. It's not a million miles, but... just with a pencil. Just gonna mark on. Now it's pissing it down. How's that for a fit? Free cock on. Now I'm not going to be able to get it out. So I just want to get some paint on this quick. So this is my Hammerite smooth white. Just going to get a bit on there. Just dab it around the raw metal. I'll just leave that to dry. So just because the weather's started to turn, I'm going to pack off for now, but I'm leaving my hole where I've painted it just to dry, and yeah, once it's dry, I'm then going to put a little bit of silicone around the hole and just hopefully press my water filler cap just onto that, and then that's another job done. Screw it all in, leave it to dry, and that's pretty much it. It's that simple, so yeah. See you in a couple of hours time. So last night I finished putting the cap on. It was quite simple, so all I had to do was put mastic around the edge of that, bang it back in, and then I just put some self-tapping screws and just screwed it in, and that's nice and solid, and that is that done for now. Until I get my water tank, I'm going for an underslung water tank. I sort of need to know where the points on that tank are going to sit. So it's mounting under the wheel arch, so underneath sort of this area here. I need to know so that I can tap my pipe under, and basically before I order any more pipe, I want to know how long I need to order it, or whether the pipe I've already got from doing this before will reach to the connection point.
Thank you for watching my video. If you found this helpful or entertaining, then please drop me a like and subscribe to catch more of my content.